Hi, my name is Nick Dyner, CEO of Moleaer. Thanks for including us at this week's conference. Today, I'm going to be talking to you a bit about nanobubbles and how they improve irrigation water quality and plant health. So growing healthy crops starts with having a high-quality irrigation water. One of the ways to improve water quality in irrigation is to add air oxygen nanobubbles. When you add oxygen nanobubbles to the irrigation water, we're going to provide four distinct benefits. We're going to use the scouring effect of the bubbles to control and prevent biofilm formation. We're going to reduce the presence of pathogens and algae that form in source water or in the irrigation water. We're going to improve plant health and plant growth and yields by elevating oxygen levels around the root zone, which in turn improves nutrient conversion and nutrient absorption. And we're going to suppress the presence of root-borne disease. One of the things that our customers will consistently see when adding air oxygen nanobubbles is improvement in root mass, and root health. Some of that is evident from the photos you see on the right, comparing the introduction of oxygen nanobubbles versus more conventional approaches using venturis or airstones to elevate oxygen levels in water. And what you can see from these images is just healthier, wider, larger roots in these leafy green examples with the addition of oxygen nanobubbles. So when we think about where we can add nanobubbles to the irrigation process, we're really talking about all sources of water, starting with the storage water tanks or ponds, some man-made, some natural, that could be outside the farm or outside the greenhouse, as evident in the picture in the top. Often these sources of water are stagnant, sitting there, sometimes in high temperatures in the summertime, and algae will form. One of the products that Moleaer offers is an air nanobubble system that consistently reduces and prevents the presence of algae in ponds, lakes, and storage water basins. We also add oxygen nanobubbles to storage water tanks, day tanks, drain water tanks, anywhere a farmer is looking to add nutrients or recover water and wants to elevate oxygen levels significantly to the saturation point before introducing that water into the root zone. So nanobubbles are highly applicable across the entire water cycle within the growing environment, from source water all the way through reclamation water. So when we're talking about nanobubbles, it's important to understand what exactly makes them unique compared to all other bubbles and all other forms of aeration. So to start with, we're not talking about nanotechnology. We're strictly talking about a unit of measurement. Nanobubbles are 100 to 120 nanometer size bubbles that, when formed, have a number of unique properties that truly distinguish them from all other bubbles. First and foremost, these bubbles, which are 2,000 times smaller than a grain of salt, lack the buoyancy to rise to the surface of the pond. Therefore, they provide a very efficient means to bring oxygen into water without having to waste a lot of oxygen or air. Why that's important? Traditional aeration systems will only dissolve up to 3% of oxygen per foot of water once the bubble is formed because the bubble is rising so rapidly. Using Moleaer nanobubble technology, we're going to dissolve between 85 and 90% or more of the oxygen into water, making pure oxygen all of a sudden very economical and very affordable. And we'll get into the benefits of why elevating oxygen is so important. Additionally, nanobubbles, because they are so small and not rising to the surface, will remain suspended in the body of water until they react or dissolve. The reactions that we care about in terms of adding added value have to do with the oxidative property of the bubble and the scouring benefits of the bubble. Let me start with oxidation. When we're talking about oxidation, we're talking about similar effects of what you find with peroxide, ozone, bleach, all used to oxidize pathogens and prevent the presence of pathogens in water. Nanobubbles will naturally do the same. When the nanobubble collapses or reacts, it will actually release an enormous amount of energy, forming a hydroxyl radical. That hydroxyl radical is a known oxidant. That oxidant will lyse algae cells or destroy the presence of pathogens like Pythium, Phytophthora, and whatnot. Additionally, think of the bubble like a hard surface or a hard pellet, obviously tiny in size. As it's moving through the irrigation system, it actually has a scouring effect. And that scouring is gonna break apart the biofilm structures that you'll find on surfaces, particularly in irrigation pipes and drip lines, helping keep the surface clean and maintain the integrity of the system. So in summary, when you're thinking about nanobubbles, you're thinking about two things: highly efficient oxygen transfer into water, making oxygen very affordable to achieve supersaturated levels, and the unique properties of these bubbles that remain suspended in water until they dissolve, that will provide oxidative benefits and scouring benefits to maintain a clean surface and a healthy body of water. Just high level how we produce nanobubbles. So our technology is highly scalable. We start at 25 gallons a minute, we go to 1,000 gallons a minute. And as water flows through what we call our nanobubble generator, we diffuse different gases in irrigation, always air or oxygen, into that flowing water to achieve supersaturated levels of dissolved oxygen and a high concentration of nanobubbles. We'll produce up to 1 billion nanobubbles per milliliter of water. It sounds like an extraordinary high number. When you think about the size of a nanobubble, again, about 100 to 120 nanometers, it's a tiny amount of volume relative to a milliliter of water. So let me touch on some case studies demonstrating the benefits of adding high levels of oxygen nanobubbles into the irrigation water. This is a customer we've worked closely with for the last 2 years now, the Revel Greens in Minnesota. They're a well-known leafy green grower under glass. And we've provided two distinct benefits to their growing that they've had an opportunity to experience, benefit from. The first is we've helped eliminate and maintain low levels of pythium in irrigation water. Pythium is a well-known pathogen that greenhouses and growers will constantly be battling with. What we're demonstrating is that high levels of oxygen plus the addition of oxygen nanobubbles into water keep pythium down to very low levels of infection. Additionally, what they've been able to see at Revel is whether it's through the reduction of disease and or the elevated levels of dissolved oxygen, in this case of 20, 25 parts per million, we've been able to increase yields fairly significantly based on the crop growing consistently over time. We also move beyond leafy greens into fruits. And here's an example of a project we did with a research partner in the Netherlands called Delphi. They were studying the effects of adding oxygen nanobubbles with elevated levels of dissolved oxygen irrigation water on strawberries. These are strawberries grown in a controlled environment in gutters as opposed to in soil. And what we were demonstrating here was that through the elevated levels of dissolved oxygen, in this case, to 3x what you can do with air, meaning going to almost 30 parts per million or milligrams per liter dissolved oxygen, we were again demonstrating disease control with Pythium phytophthora, but also showing significant yield improvement, 14% yield improvement over the growing period. Tomatoes, obviously being the largest crop grown under glass and perhaps the most important crop relative to market size and opportunity. In this particular study, we worked with another research partner called Nova Crop Control in the Netherlands, looking at, again, benefits of adding high levels of oxygen nanobubbles to irrigation water. And as you can see from the first two case studies and this one, we're always focused on two distinct things: improving water quality with pathogen control and how elevated levels of oxygen plus oxygen nanobubbles are going to improve fruit development or crop development, ultimately yield. In this case, another good example, improving water quality translating to low levels of infection of Pythium and how that translates ultimately to a larger crop. In this case, 8 to 10% yield improvement on tomatoes. We've also started to branch the technology to outdoor farms, focused primarily on specialty crops, avocados, citrus, nuts, table grapes, etc. In this particular case, with one of our partners in Chile, we were looking at adding oxygen nanobubbles to the drip irrigation systems for avocados. And in this particular project, what we're showing with adding oxygen nanobubbles to the irrigation water is not only better plant health in terms of measured by tip burn and a reduction in presence of tip burn, but ultimately how that translated to a larger avocado. And you can see here in both circumference and lengths, the distinct improvement adding oxygen nanobubbles to irrigation to improve the avocado growing environment translated to a larger product. Additionally, citrus, we've seen similar benefits to what you saw before in avocado. Another example of adding oxygen nanobubbles to a specialty crop environment in an outdoor grow. Here, similar to what we're doing with yield improvements and disease control, we're helping accelerate the time to harvest for the mandarin groves. So in this particular case, not only increasing the sugar content, the Brix content, we're also bringing more mandarins to a orange color, meaning a more valuable color metric on the chart at a higher percentage or higher concentration. So again, directly to the economic value of adding oxygen nanobubbles to the farm and the farmer's growing. Blueberries, similar case. Adding oxygen nanobubbles is demonstrating not only a better root health, root development, but translating directly to fruit size and fruit yield. This is another project we've done in Chile, where most of our outdoor specialty crop application development, crop development in terms of proof cases have been conducted so far. Cannabis has been a more interesting story for us. We worked here at the University of Wageningen, one of the leading universities in horticulture, agriculture research in the Netherlands. In this particular project, the University of Wageningen was putting together what they call high-end next-generation technologies to find the most optimal advanced cannabis growing environment for future cannabis cultivation. The one thing we've seen across all of our crops is that cannabis loves oxygen more so than any other crop, consistently getting double-digit yield improvements when you add oxygen nanobubbles to the irrigation water, regardless if it's grown in rock wool or peat or other substrates. And in this particular case with Wageningen's research, we were showing consistent yield improvements in every single trial we did with them, ultimately to a 24% yield increase. We also saw higher THC concentrations in a nanobubble crop versus the control crop. And I think the 20 to 30 different customers we have today growing cannabis using oxygen nanobubbles in irrigation water will tell you that they consistently see this type of yield improvement, this type of THC improvement, and a much healthier crop coming out of the grow when adding oxygen nanobubbles to the water. As I mentioned at the very beginning, not only are we adding oxygen nanobubbles to the irrigation, but we've also started to see farmers and customers using our product with just air to improve source water quality in the irrigation ponds. Here's an example of a pond, man-made storage pond outside of a greenhouse in the Netherlands that is being used to catch stormwater, rainwater, runoff, and holding water. They were using peroxide before to maintain water quality and prevent algae blooms. They've replaced peroxide with a percentage of the peroxide with just our air nanobubble generator, where we're adding air nanobubbles into the water, which does elevate dissolved oxygen, not as significantly as you will with pure oxygen. But more importantly, the oxidative benefit of the bubble is helping prevent the formation of algae and toxic algae blooms, and also reducing the work on the biofilter, the amount of maintenance needed to continue to clean out the filter that's being used from the source water into the irrigation water. We've done a similar project in Canada. This is a natural storage pond that's being used for irrigation for the greenhouses there. And it's a 5 million gallon irrigation pond. And what we were measuring here was very similar to the previous project, but rather than focusing just on algae, we're also looking at turbidity, which is a good metric of what kind of downstream issues you're going to have with filtration and water quality management from the source water, ultimately the irrigation. And again, what's happening is we're adding air nanobubbles to oxidize the presence of different types of pathogens and algae, and also elevating oxygen levels, particularly near the sediment, where it's very hard to bring oxygen to the bottom unless you use nanobubble technology, which is like blowing smoke into a room. The bubbles will travel everywhere, evenly oxygenating the entire water column. And as a result, we promote beneficial bacteria that's going to digest the muck, consume any of the nutrients that are there, and ultimately reduce the suspended solid load in the water, which we measure both by turbidity as well as the presence of algae, where chlorophyll is a good surrogate for that. In terms of the products we offer into this space, so as I mentioned earlier, our core technology is scalable in terms of flows. We start 25 gallons a minute. We go up to 1,000 gallons a minute. We have about 175 of these systems now in greenhouses globally, primarily in North America, Canada, Western Europe, and Latin America. All of our customers will be using anywhere from 25 gallons a minute to 250 gallons a minute. We offer our low-flow products that we call the Bloom, which get connected to an external oxygen or gas source. And on the right, we have the Neo, which goes up to 250 gallons a minute and includes an integrated oxygen concentrator on board. So that's for the customer, for the farmer who doesn't want to go source oxygen from a third-party gas supplier. And then the Clear, the product in the middle, which is green because it's designed to be outdoors near a pond, storage basin, or a lake, and is providing just air nanobubbles with an integrated air compressor into that body of water to maintain the quality and health. Some examples of what it looks like installed. You can see it looks very simple to install, which it is. It's plug and play. It can sit on alongside a pond or a lake. It can be connected to tanks. You can see it being connected to oxygen cylinders in the top left. We also have examples like the one on the bottom right where it comes with an integrated oxygen generator. And we do offer systems that get integrated in line if you already are pumping and just want to add nanobubbles into your existing pumping network, so that we would provide you just the core technology without the pump or the gas source and for you to integrate into your existing piping. Thanks. Appreciate you taking the time to listen. And if you have any questions, we'll be around during the conference to answer them. Thanks very much.